In many ways, Italy is the future. Yes, the political system is completely corrupt. In other places where it's not yet so corrupt, the chances are that politics will go the same way as it has in Italy. There's a risk that it could go that way. Not to the same extent in all places, but all national political institutions in other countries are going to have a hard time being able to function when they become stranded assets. So I think the political system in Italy, it's parasitic, it's completely corrupt. I would say ignore the politicians completely, because to do anything else only encourages them. So I just ignore the political system, focus on the grassroots where the differences can actually be made. And the interesting advantages that Italy has really lie at the grassroots. Well, they lie in the fact that already nobody is looking for solutions from the top down. They've written off politicians as being sources of solutions. But also, they are more able to look after themselves, not equally everywhere in Italy, but in a lot of places where there are strong community and family ties, people are already used to looking after themselves to a greater extent, because they've always had to. They know how to live like that. Other parts of the world, that isn't true. In many parts of the world, families are spread at a great distance. People don't know their neighbors. Civic engagement has disintegrated. Civil society has really fallen apart in many ways. People don't come out and work together in the way that they used to. So in places where people still do that, that's a tremendous advantage. So Italy has more of that than many, many other places do. And there's a lot that can be built on. I think if we try and build on that foundation that already exists, with slightly more formal mechanisms like time banks, for instance, or local currencies, which I realize are currently illegal, but eventually people will simply do what they have to do, and we will see other forms of transactions, means of accounting for transactions will naturally emerge, and they will have to. We can build on all of these mechanisms of coming together, and this helps to scale up the connections that already exist in the grassroots. So you have to try and extend trust further than it currently lies. And by using things like time banking or local currencies, that is a mechanism for doing that. And anything that people come together to do, whether it's community gardens or time banking or anything else, anything people come together to do will build social capital. And this builds on relationships of trust. So all of these things are very much a part of a solution in the sense of giving us the best possible outcome. It won't look like business as usual, but nothing we can possibly do will give us business as usual. All we can do is try and get through this as best we possibly can with the least pain for the greatest number of people. So all of these initiatives that come from the ground up are the best hope we have of building a different future. And in places like Italy, where the foundation already exists to a much greater extent than in many other places, that is going to be a critical advantage.